Hey everyone, welcome back to another video, and in this tutorial video I'm gonna show you how you can install Bernedit to Minecraft, including Minecraft Forge, Minecraft Fabric, and also Spigot or Paper Minecraft server. So you can see the timestamps on the screen if you are only looking for Fabric or Minecraft server, but if you're looking for Forge, it will start immediately. Open up your browser first and search for Minecraft Forge. And the first result is the files.minecraftforge.net, and as you can see, Minecraft Forge is available from 1.1 to 1.17. I'm just gonna use the 1.17 one, so let's skip this add window and save the file. I'm just gonna save it to the desktop. Second of all, we are gonna need Bernedit because that's what we want to install. And we are gonna need the Bernedit mod, so not the plugin. As you can see, here's the CurseForge site. Search for the correct version that you want. I'm just gonna use this Bernedit beta version, which supports 1.17.1, and it is compatible with Minecraft Forge and Minecraft Fabric. So let's just save it. Okay, if you also want Optifine, you're gonna need to get it now. If you don't, you can simply skip this section. So I'm just gonna use the 1.17 preview version, the newest available. Hit this download button, save to the desktop, save, and you can close this browser now. So we got these three files here, and you only need to open the Forge installer. So let's open it, and as you can see what it says, install client. So hit OK, it's gonna take a couple of seconds, and if it's done, it should say that you have successfully installed this client, so blah, blah, blah. So you can delete this file and this log file, and you're gonna need the Bernedit and the Optifine if you downloaded it. So open up your file manager and type the following text into this bar. And you're gonna need to open the .minecraft folder. So this is the location, your C drive, users, your username, app data, roaming, and .minecraft finally. And you're gonna need to find a folder called mods here. If you don't have a folder called mods, you can simply create one, so it's that easy. If you already have mods here, you need to delete them or just move them to another location. And let's copy the Bernedit and the Optifine if you downloaded Optifine. So that's it. And let's test it out quickly to make sure that it worked. Choose the Forge profile before launching the game. Click on play and it should take a couple of seconds to load. For some weird reason it crashed with Optifine, probably because Optifine is still a preview version and it's still in beta, so you can't really use Optifine, but in a couple of weeks probably it will work just fine. So yeah, that's it. But looks like without Optifine it launched, and as you can see, 3 mods loaded. And if I press mods, you can see the word edit here. So if I go to single player and join a random word, I just made this word for this particular video. Okay, hopefully the lag is gone, or at least I can see now some recording. And as you can see, I can choose the first position, second position, and it's just working all fine. Like, I can fill this area with air, and nothing happened actually, because yeah, I mean, it filled it. So yeah, the leaf disappeared. So okay, it's working. Now let's move on to the Fabric version. So for Fabric, you're gonna need a little bit more things. And let's start it right now. So open up your browser and search for Fabric MC without caps lock, because you don't need caps lock. So you're gonna need to land on this site, and you're gonna need the Fabric loader and the Fabric API. So let's choose the loader first. So the universal jar, let's save it to the desktop, it's all fine. And also the Fabric API is important, without it it will not really work. Choose the correct version for 1.17, so choose the correct version, save it. And finally, let's get word edit, if I can type it. So, as I said in the Forge part, if you've seen it, if you're not, it's not a problem. This particular version of WordEdit compatible with Forge and Fabric, so just choose the, no, not this one, I'm gonna use the 1.17.1 version. Also save this to the desktop, and that's it. So we have basically everything, but if you also want Optifine, you're gonna need to get Optifine, but Optifine can't natively run with Fabric, so you're gonna need a piece of software called OptiFabric, and yeah, so this version and choose the correct version, and finally let's get Optifine if you want. I mean, I said it's optional, you don't need to get it if you don't want. You can just install WordEdit without Optifine, and I already have it downloaded, so I just replaced it. So yeah, we got a bunch of files here, and what you have to do is the Fabric installer. So double click on it, choose the Minecraft version that you want, click on install, and it should be done in a couple of seconds. I already installed it, so it was done immediately for me. So you can delete this Fabric installer now, and you're gonna need these to put these four. So let's just copy them into the update location of your game. So is the C drive users your username, AppData roaming, so this is the location, and the .minecraft folder, and find a folder here called mods. If you don't have one, simply create one, delete or move to another place the existing ones here, and paste these four, so Fabric API and WordEdit, and if you want Optifine, OptiFabric and Optifine. Well, that's a lot of things. So let's open up the Minecraft launcher to test it, and let's choose the Fabric loader here and the correct version behind it, and hopefully it works because it's still in beta. Okay, it's crashed. So for some weird reason this preview Optifine doesn't really work with WordEdit, so you're gonna need to play without Optifine until there is a more stable version available, but hopefully we will not get an error without Optifine. Yeah, it's working. So there is some issue with this particular version of Optifine. I don't know why, so you're gonna need to wait for an update which will arrive in a week or 2 weeks. So let's test it out quickly. And as you can see, you already have this wooden axe here. The lag is insane. I should wait a couple of seconds. And as you can see, I can select the first and the second position, and I can fill it with like stone or something. So yeah, WordEdit is working completely fine. So yeah, there is no Optifine yet, but probably an update should fix it. So yeah, and finally let's see how you can install it to a server. Okay, for the server installation, open up your browser and search for WordEdit. But instead of downloading the WordEdit mod, we are gonna need the WordEdit for bucket. So if you have a Spigot or a paper server or a bucket server, you can use it. Choose the correct version. I'm just gonna use the newest one because it's the newest one. Let's just download this file. Save this file to the desktop, for example, and open up the folder of your server. If you don't have a server, I have like a bunch of tutorials for Minecraft servers. I will leave some links in the description. So you should have a plugins folder here, and as you can see, I already have WordEdit installed, but I'm just gonna do it again. So let's just put in the plugins folder and start the server again. Okay, so let's connect to the multiplayer server here. As you can see, I am logged in. For some weird reason, it's logging very heavily. I don't know why. As you can see, I can select first and second position, I can fill it up with stone or something like that. Yeah, so it's all working and all fine. So yeah, that's it for today, folks. Thanks for watching and see you soon. Bye bye.